So open data. A lot of fantastic data has been opened up by the public sector all over the world over the course of the last few years. And when my slides come up, you will actually see a blue circle that represents all of the great open data that has been opened up. There's actually more of it out than most of us realize. What we've seen so far in terms of using that data is that we've seen entrepreneurs, clever developers, and designers take small parts of that data and make apps out of it. And making that data super useful, super engaging, super easy to use. And there are actually quite a lot of these applications out there, each taking their own little pocket of the data that has been opened up. So here we have the slides. Here is the world of open data. Here is the data taken by a single app and made useful to us, in an innovative way, and that's fantastic. And there are quite a lot of those apps out there, each taking their own little pocket of the world of open data and making it easy for us to use, super useful, engaging, and even fun to use, as we've seen this morning. And that's great. But the fact of the matter is that the bulk of this data sits there, known to few and used by even fewer. It just lies there waiting to be used and turned into value. Let's take the world of energy data as an example. So when Todd and his crew kicked this off back in May, they pointed us to a lot of different open energy data sources. We have the EPA's website. They have their own system, a lot of interesting data there. The EIA has several different systems on their website. The data is in different places and so on. We have Department of Energy. We have the National Renewable Energy Laboratory. We have climate change data, we have more from the DOA, a different system. We have IPCC data, and so on and so forth. And these are just a few of the sources that are out there. And not only are they in different places, they're also in different formats. We'll have an Excel sheet here, a PowerPoint there, a PDF there, SPSS files, CSV files, different XML formats, and so on and so forth. Let alone all the proprietary systems that have their own data models and their own APIs and so on. So not only is the data heterogeneous in location, it's also heterogeneous in format. And this is actually quite familiar to us at Datamarket. What we do, what our technology does, is it takes heterogeneous data from heterogeneous data sources, reads it in, normalizes it, and stores it in our systems in a single data model, making it all super easy to find and understand. So what we've done here is that we've taken data from these great providers of energy data. We've taken all the quantitative data that we could find, time series data, survey data, and so on, and made it all available through a single portal. In addition to some of the US sources, we've also added some of the international open sources that are out there. And the best way, so actually, this is what I'm here to introduce today. Datamarket Energy, your portal to the world of energy. And the best way to understand what it's all about is actually to see a little demo. So we have a video of that. We go. So yeah, the front page gives you a little bit of an overview of what the data that is there. But the best way to find the data is actually just to type in a query as you would on Google. It searches through all this data. So for renewable capacity, we have 9 matches. The matches look a little bit like Google search results. We have a title, we see the data provider, and we see the time span covered by this data. But what happens if you click one of the results is very different from what happens on Google. Instead of taking you off to a third-party website, clicking this data set, for example, will immediately show you a view of the data, showing how renewable energy capacity has developed over time. And on the left-hand side, we have the rest of the data that is available in this single data set. So here we're breaking down the renewable data sources to see the composition. And when we hit visualize, we see that it's wind that's actually kicking in the last decade or so there. We can change the data view so we can stack them up to see what they look like when they're stacked up, or we can switch to a bar chart, for example, to show the composition in a single year. The time slider underneath the graph then enables you to pick any time span or time point that you want, and we see that back in 1987, conventional hydroelectric power was pretty much the only renewable data source out there, so a lot has happened since. So back to the slides, please. So what else might we find here? We might find gasoline prices in Massachusetts. We might find primary, so basically energy production by source. Blue is fossil fuels. Yellow is renewable energy. Still some work to do there. This data and the data set before it comes from the EIA. From Oak Ridge National Laboratory, we have car registrations from all over the world. And there are a few other things in there. All in all, we already have about 2 million time series about energy data, of energy data available in data market, coming from about 10,000 data sources across 13 data providers, and they hold about 50 million facts about the world of energy, all ready to search, visualize, compare, and download in your favorite data format, mind you, from data market energy. Regardless of the origin, whether it was an Excel sheet from the EPA's website or data from the new and great electricity price API that the EIA just launched, whose data we mostly have in our system already, was launched a week ago. This is actually new business for us, enabled by open data from organizations such as these that we've seen here. It's new business for us. In taking the data that is already there, we're not taking anything away from the value that has already been released by the data, by putting the data out there. Quite the contrary, we're adding value on top of it and making that available to those that are willing to pay for the increased discoverability, productivity, and usefulness of the data once it's in the system. So again, new business enabled by open data. We're launching this commercially later this month. Data Market Energy will be available on energy.datamarket.com, and you can actually go there today to read more about the service and sign up for a free trial as we go live. Thank you very much.